ATN World News. News and inspiration with Leah Tillock.
Hello and welcome to ATN World News. I'm Leah, and it's great to be with you, the listeners around the world. Well, today most people will tell you that I have been talking about this interview coming up with my particular guest because I'm so thrilled to have this artist with, a gifted voice, Bob Carlisle. Before I introduce you to him, I'm going to give you a little couple of bio lines of Bob here for those who are just being introduced to Bob. He's known for his amazing gifted voices. Look up some YouTubes of him, and you'll see what people have to say in the comment section underneath. He's had really a stunning body of musical work. In his early years alone with his band Allies for 9 years, many today are still really diehard fans, you know, of their music in that group. And his solo career was even more amazing because it was during his solo years he achieved worldwide acclaim, Grammy, Dove Awards, with a chart-crossing song, Butterfly Kisses. Yeah, you know that song, and you may know Bob by now. So with all that, Bob, I'd like to say good evening.
Good evening, Leah. Thank you for having me on. I've never been on World News before.
Well, I think that you are a good topic of news that the world wants to hear about. So, honestly, Bob, I know that you have had critical acclaim for songs that, as I say, were knocked out of the ballpark, heard worldwide. Not just the Christian body, but it really broke ground into the secular music, which was people you wanted to reach. I mean, the first question I have to ask you, your voice is gifted. It really is. It's a step above. I just want to ask you about your talent and the amazing things God has given you on it. First question. What's your thought?
The idea that I attempted to cross over from Christian music into the pop secular world is really kind of ridiculous. That song, I think you're referring to Butterfly Kisses, was just a song that I wrote for my daughter, and I played it for her. She ran around with it on a cassette for probably a year or so before I ever put it on the record. And I wasn't sure anybody even wanted to hear a sappy song about a guy and his kid, you know, but everybody insisted that I put it on, and God just did his thing. I wasn't doing it to try to evangelize the world. It was a very personal song, and just everybody took it to heart, and I'm so grateful for that. And if God used it in some way, which I know he did, bringing the hearts of fathers to their children, you know, I'm just so terribly grateful for that.
Well, absolutely. I think it was a crushing blow to the abortion movement. It helped people to realize the gift and the joy that a child brings to your life, the love.
It's bigger than you and me. I'm very grateful for that.
Absolutely. I'm going to go back a little bit with you, Bob. You really came to great recognition with the group, the Allies. And personally, my favorite is Crying in the Chapel. People, my listeners, listen, please go to YouTube if you've not heard this. Can't find the Pavarotti of Christian music on this song. Never in my life heard a man wail on a song like this. Please go, it's stunning.
Yeah, well, Allies was my first Christian band that I had gotten serious about being in. We made nine records, and I loved those guys. It was just hometown guys, man. We all got together and did it. You know, Crying in the Chapel, obviously Elvis did that song, and I always loved it, but I didn't want to do it the way Elvis did it, you know, because we're a rock band, but I also didn't want to disrespect it. So we did it kind of as a quartet kind of feel, and after that song was released, the guy, right now his name escapes me, and I'm embarrassed, but he wrote that song for Elvis, or he'd written it long before Elvis did it, but Elvis did it, and he came to one of our concerts, and met up with us backstage and told us he liked our version better than Elvis's. And I was so proud at that moment, and he autographed the original sheet music to it, and I was very happy to see that. I loved Allies. Allies was a great band. We were together for 10 years, and after 9 records, it was just time to let it close.
Yes, and focus on your solo, and I think that's a great gift that he autographed, you know, the original copy. That's priceless. You know, that song. Yeah, part of your cool treasure collection there, you know? I know that Randy was in with the Jesus movement of music and
was
a part of the group, and that you two both have teamed up in co-writing songs going into your solo career. Am I correct?
Oh, yeah. We've written just catalogs of songs together back during the Allies times and also during my solo career. We've written a lot of songs for other artists as well. When I write and sing songs, I never write songs to point fingers at anyone. I never write songs that start off with the word you. So they're always about me. If I'm going to sing about shortcomings, I'll sing about mine. If I'm going to sing about joys, I'll sing about mine. If I'm going to sing about sins, which are plentiful, I'll sing about mine. I don't stand on a platform, cause that, frankly, that's just a little too far to fall for me. I just sing about my joys and shortcomings and my joy of being saved by the precious grace of Jesus Christ. And people can relate to that. I found that more than not. People really relate to you telling your story because it happens to be their story too. And with all the songs I've written, obviously Butterfly Kisses is one too. That people had such pathos for, but it was all of my songs. I've got a whole bunch of them.
Oh, I know you wrote from your heart, and that is what reaches people, is originality coming from your heart.
Well, I've written my share of stupid songs, you know, and I won't shy away from that. I've written my share of stupid pop fluff for the sake of trying to quote unquote get somewhere with them. But it wasn't until I really came to a realization that if I just write things that are important to me and things that I'm passionate about and things that I feel strongly about, that God provided an audience for that. You know, if you're always chasing something, you'll never catch it. So I stopped chasing pop and culture and all that comes with it, and just started writing about things that are important to me. And it wasn't until I did that God saw fit to touch it the way he did.
Name for us, Bob, a couple of songs that really mean a lot to you and why.
There's a lot of them. Oh, there's a song called We Fall Down. We Fall Down, which is was one of my favorites. It's a story about the contrast between our sin and God's grace and what the real connection is there, you know. And I've got just so many songs. It's so hard to name a few. Let's see. I've got one called Father's Love, which is a song that I wrote for my son. I sang that with the Nashville Symphony Orchestra. And... oh, just so many songs. It's hard to pick a few.
I can imagine, because you have such a library of, you know, wealth in songs there. Mm-hmm. And yes, you did write a song for your son as well, Father's Love. And I'm sure our audience would like to know about your kids. You've got grandkids now? What's going on?
Oh, yeah, I got grandkids. My kids are grown and out of the house now. So now I've got two grandkids on my daughter's side and one grandson on my son's side. And they're just the absolute recipients of everything I've got to give.
Oh, you just must love that.
Oh, and they love me. Grandpa's got the goods.
I'm sure that you do, and I'm sure you enjoy, you know, every moment.
Oh, yeah.
Where do you see yourself going now this year. I know that you're thinking about a few things and thinking about doing even more this year with music. Well, where are you going now, Bob?
I don't know. I'm asking God that question. I have been semi-retired for quite some time now, just enjoying my family and my grandkids and life, and I have been really feeling pulled to get back out there, but not for the same reasons that I used to be pulled. It's not about the career and all the money and everything. It's about just going out and being. I miss being an active part of the body of Christ and giving what I have to give and being a part of something. And is no longer chasing anything, you know. I just feel the urge to get back out into churches and just fellowship and sing and be a part of it. And if that's what God wants me to do, He'll open the doors for it. You know, I put the bug in my friend and agent's ear to be on the lookout, and a few offers are coming in that I love. I would love to come to some churches, and I have what I think is a really nice delivery system for them, and I think they'll really enjoy it. And I hope that I can really affect them when I come and not just entertain them. That's my goal. If anybody would like to have me to their church or an event, go to my booking Facebook page. It's Bob Carlisle Music, I think it is, on Facebook. And Alex Tresos is my agent. He his phone number's on there, and you can contact him. He does all that stuff.
Absolutely. I'm just letting people know he's not just this wonderful, talented voice. He's very sincere. And that's something
he's really
that
good looking. He's really good looking, too.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Forgot that part.
That's crazy for me not to say that, because absolutely, you have time.
I mean, you know, while we're on that road,
might just as well throw that in there. But yeah. I'll show you his videos, and you'll see that he is so good looking there. Okay.
Oh, it'll amaze you.
Yeah, you can see it with that. Well, speaking of some of your fantastic works, Bob. I always ask this. I know it's a common question, but it's deep for every artist, and it's different for every artist. What moment in time in your musical life stands out for you more than any other?
Well, there have been so many. There's just been so many. It's really hard to pick one specific event, one specific moment. I think more than anything else, is just as you get older, you're able to look back on your life and realize that God really did keep you in play, and He really did guide movement around you. I mean, it's just miraculous. When you get older, you realize the things that God has done that you didn't really took for granted kind of when you were younger. I think one concert I did, it was a Luis Palau event somewhere in the world, and my son was with me, and he was, I guess, maybe 11 or 12 years old at the time, and he went forward and accepted Christ that night, and that was one that'll never leave my memory. I bounced off that stage so fast and grabbed onto him. That was a precious night for me. But, you know, just in general, it's been so fun. But my mind is different now than it was then. I'm more concerned about just being fulfilled in God's movement in my life and not trying to chase something. I'm not chasing anything anymore. There's nothing I want, really. I've been very fortunate. I don't really want stuff. I just want to be a part of the body of Christ and to give to them from this well that I think I have to give from, and just bless people's hearts.
That's beautiful. Well, people, you can download this from our iTunes. You can hear about the information Bob gave of how you can book him, or go on Facebook, look up his name. His booking agent is there, Alex. And I'd like you to stay on the line for a couple of minutes. We'll put you in the screen room after this. But listen, we've been nothing but blessed that you shared your mind and your heart with us today, what was on it.
Thank you.
I want to thank you so much for being on tonight. Thank you, Bob.
It was my pleasure. Thank you very much.
Stood alone with a young and frightened father who knew something wasn't wrong. He said, "Son, this isn't easy, but we really need to talk." So he put his arm around him and they began to walk. He said, "Your wife is finally sleeping. She just needs to be alone right now. And your baby, well, she's healthy, but there's something you should know. Son, she's slightly less than perfect. There was nothing we could do. So before you go to see her, I thought I'd talk to you." As the young man held the warm and sleeping bundle to his chest, he saw the imperfections, and although he tried his best, he couldn't stop the tears from falling as he held his little girl. And in a low and trembling voice, he gently said, you're